Welcome to the day 18 of our adventure. That's open. Yeah, register. One single letter. And a single integer. And the register to start with 0. Recovers the frequency of the last sound played. Bounding. Okay. We have a sample. Blah, blah, blah. And the sample result is 4. Okay. That's what is the value of the recovered frequency? Most recent interface sound. Okay. So let's write the test. Actually, I want to add a new file. Day 18 sample. Okay. Then I will have sample equal audit file also day 18 sample. We'll take the sample and expected value to be 4. Okay. And what we want to do? So I'll want to have a parser. Again, I prefer a parsec. So I'll have a of input that will give me a run, I think. parser spaces on the input, and this I want to choice from parser default. So my test is something like read instructions of input, expect some success. Run faster. Come on. Here. So expect success, fail to read the instructions, and if I manage to read the instructions, then get recovered frequency of those instructions, and that should be the expected value, and this is in the parsers. Ah, I understand now the problem. Oh, okay. Okay, no more red. I want to see that it's failing. In the meantime, I will need what? An abstract syntax tree. Let's see. Okay, I have a failure. Super. So a sound actually, let's see again the input. Some of the is a character. Sound of car. What does a set of character and value and need? Add. Multiply. Modulo. Recover. Okay, so a single argument only found and recovered. So this will be character. Everything else has two arguments. Okay. Let's see. Let's create parsers for the for those. It's a sound and spaces and a letter, and that I want to map it to a sound. Okay, then I have a set. Actually, this first part is identical for all of those. So let's extract this. Label of label. Label of the sound will be the label of sound. It's a capital L here. So of the label of set, and I want to take that value and continue with spaces actually like that. And a value, and this actually I want to have the both sides of that, and this I map it to a set. Yeah, I need another. Okay. Actually, let's make another primitive. Let value equal spaces and this will be a lot nicer now because because I can type like this to a lot cleaner, less noise. But this is not a set, this is an add. Let's multiply. modulo. Okay. What else? Recovers. With the label RTB. This will be just that. Okay. And jumps. Okay, this is not needed, and I want something that will, I need to see again the set on one row each, so let's type it here actually. Let create instruction will be spaces with choice of the sound, the add, close this. The multiply. The modulo, the recovers, and the jumps. Okay, and I want to run many P instructions. Faster, and I have a list of instructions. Okay, so let's see what else. I need a list of registers, so a nice thing is to define the domain model. Okay, so I need to instantiate that. Okay. And for every instruction, I need to is a list of poll of my current state. And my current state will be what? Because of jumps, I cannot use hold. Then I will have a recursive function. That will need what? The current position. And I need to most recently play sound. So I need to have the last recovered sound. So let's create a type. State of type record that will have a position and a sound. So this will be a state. Okay. The instructions is already here. The registers will be a closure. So, what? If the position, the instruction, actually I want to stop first. So if, let's have the number of instructions here. Actually, let's not optimize so much. So if instructions list length, yes, is smaller or equal with my state position, or state position is lower than actually what if this is bigger or smaller than zero. Then state last sound else match the instructions of state position. Wait. And here I will have all my I will have a pattern matching for all my type of instructions, and I need to call this with a new state, and the new state will be the position will be zero and the last play sound let's put it zero also, but an option will be a better approach here in an enterprise. kind of logic. So I have to require stay. Oh, I have an input file. Okay. Let's see. Actually, let's take those. So the sound will receive a label, a register, and let's see what is done. Place a sound with a frequency equal to the value of x. So we need to store that that last play thing. So the position will be the next position. And the last play sound will be the registers last sound will be the registers value. Of my my label, and I need to create that function. Actually, I want to add an utility function. I don't like to type that all over. So, so I find of key and dictionary, and my dictionary will be of type dictionary of a and b equal match dictionary try get value of e with true and sum value and sum of value, otherwise none. And the dictionary is in the collection generics. Okay. So now I can use that. Will be the that try find and I need to provide the key and the details. And this will return me an option. Or default. Default value of 0. Okay. So where I was? Ah, here. And I get a register value. Okay. The next one. Set of a register and value. We'll do what? We'll do the following things. Registers of register will take the value B. And I need to go to the next position. So I'll have a state with position equal state position plus 1. Okay. And actually, let's see. So the set is set in this value. Increase the register value by the value of y. So register of f and take the value get register value of R, and I need to add the value. Change the state like before. Okay. Let's create a function to look nicer. Let next of state equal actually. So this will be next state. Next state. Register and value. And I can but instead of this, we multiply. What happened here? Okay. So now multiply the register with okay, the modulo is the value of the register by y. Okay, so again can same. I didn't get everything. So this will be modulo. doesn't things that is not used. Okay, let's see what the recover does. This problem is boring. I already did similar problems in the past on advent of course this year, so recovers the frequency of the last pawn played, but only when the value is not zero. So I need to get the value. It's not that. It's just on the register. So if get register value. Is the value of f, and it was not zero. If it's not zero, then what? What means recover? I need to stop. So then my state would be for the position will be minus one, and the last sound actually will be a state with this thing. The current state. So I stop else. Just jump to the next state. Okay. And the last one. I need to go what? I need to read the value from the register X, and if that value is greater than zero, I need to go to the position. Okay. So if get a register of f and is greater than zero, then I need to state position plus b. Else next state. This is kind of the highlighting is kind of funny. So, I return a state, and I need to, for all those, I need to look, to execute instruction. Okay. Mm. No hay stores. Why is it so slow? What did I change? Oh, that one, okay. Okay, let's do this. Don't know the next is. Why I don't have here the types. No, let's do it. I see a lot of problems that kind of funny the way it looks. Okay, 960. It's a dictionary, and Earth is a character. Why is this misbehaving here? For this, we'll take the value from. Ah, come on. Okay. Everything already disappeared, so let's try it. It thinks that I have a map. Oh, I need to change the name then. It's too similar. Oh, where was the error? It was in puzzle 3. Let's see the place. Yeah, here I had an actual map. Okay, let's rename it then. Actually, where's the publisher? Those ones I think are too big. 3. of it like this for the moment. Out of the domain. And I have here what is the map defined? Let's go back here. What to do, what to do? Let's change the name. Try find in dictionary would be the logic and I'm okay with it. So put this here and build. Those are in inverse. I want to change that also. So what is the expected thing? Let's put it like that. Come on. Okay. And the message will be nicer now. So I returned a zero value. And his expectation was a 4. I have an initial value here of 0. And I never got to save a last sound. So my state position is is equal to 0 actually. So this is false, and this is also false. So I get here. And I should have some what to do to see past the thing. Let's print the state. Run it again. Just one state. What I'm passing here? The instructions. Many instructions. Let's see the instructions also. I have no instruction. Interesting. So this run is a parser. And the instruction is a choice between models. Let's check the sample. I have a sample. Then if I read the out, if I read the sample, I read it with the date in sample. This is a call function. Yeah. Happening here. Instructions. The instructions is running the parser on the inputs and the many at least one. Let's do it like this. Now I should see on a failure of the parser. I don't have a set. Actually, I have a set. Okay. So I have a multiply of letter and letter. Oh, where is the input? So the second value can be also a register. Okay. The p value that can be Dot O. A number that will go to a number or a letter that will go to register. And all those here have a value. Okay. What else? V. Now it's a value. So I need a function that will get me a value. So if I have a number, it's the value V. Okay. V, otherwise I should do this. Put it like this. Get register value of R, and this it is a number. So get value, get value, get value. Get that. So actually, okay. Already have 6 seconds of test. Not a good thing. Everything went fine. Let's remove the logging because it's not needed anymore. What I had here and here. And let's the father input. Okay. The input. Okay. Comment this, and this is a read file of the 18 input. expected value to be minus 1. This should be commented. Oh, everything is still green. Let's see a red test. So I have here also a value. So I need this parser instead of plabel, pstring that will take the p value. And not add will be jumps. We found that one more set as found. And this thing will have a value. Okay, that means this thing is a get value. And what? And try again. Boring. What? It's not so boring then. What? Let's see the input again. Ah, big values. If I multiply this with this, let's try that. So instead of int, will be on int 64. And 64 and the registers also in 64. I know this. Okay. Different value. assume that was the problem. Yeah. Okay. Right again to see that everything is green. And let's see the second part. Read the fucking manual. Yeah. Run twice at the same time. So each running copy of a own set of registers and follows. Different speeds. And x sends the value of x. I assume that is a register. To the other program. These values wait in a queue. And receive the next value and stores in a register. If no value in the queue, the program waits for a value to be sent to it. So I need to have two queues. And I need to put in a register P the 0 or 1. Deadlock and both termin. How many times program will send the value? Oh, this is a nice problem. A concurrency thing. So mailbox processor with a queue that can receive. And I'll have a get value from the queue and a put value in the queue. And if the queue is empty, yeah, it can block, so mailbox processor with a timeout on receive will solve this. But that is for pussies. I want to make it different. I want to use popback. So, let's see. Actually, I want both of those stuff on. The channels. The channels from Parvac to the rescue. The synchronous thing. I can send and not be blocked. Bound and mailbox. Okay, let's see here, not here, here. Ah, I have here the operation. So, send. That will never block. And take. Okay, so I will need to use a mailbox. My sound is just move that. What? Come on. Wow. What is happening here? Please don't do that. Redo. So it's the controller. Ouch. Redo. Redo. Come on. Not this thing. So this was the value. What was the value? Okay, I don't have the value. Run it again and take the value. So let's write the test. In the meantime, interesting problem. They in sample take this and put it here. Okay, then go back here and take this and put it here. Okay, so the pathers are good to go. I will not change the sound and the cover. Actually, I can change. Sand and I took those to have a clear separation. Between. Okay. So the registers remain the same. I needed to what? To count. So the state will be different. So this will go down here. Okay. What else? Everything is the same then. I need to run this, yes. Let's implement this. I with instructions. Okay. And this will be part 2. Get bread. And we'll see later what exactly will happen. I need a sample. And the sample is sample 2. It's somehow similar, so sample 2. And I need to three times. And what do we hear? Okay. And I want to focus only on this for the moment. So what will be different? I will have this logic that is similar actually. Come on. So I'll have a position. This in 64 is in 64. Ah, is the new data set is a sample 2. Okay. So it was on the sound. I also have a value. So it's a string. That will take the value from the value, and this is a value now, and that means we'll fail somewhere here in part 1. Value sound here. Get value now. And I have a red thing here. Yeah, I get that because it's commented. Actually, let's uncomment this. And let's uncomment this. And see that at least the parsing is going. So I need to have one for each of those engines. for each of those engines, I need to have one pipe going and one pipe coming back. So I need to create those. What was the name for it? Zero and one. Okay. Instructions. What else? A channel. And a channel to receive the data. Okay, let's move those like that so to be easier to follow. The fonts are too big. Actually, this weird engine is here. I think it can get some smaller off. Okay. And we'll see later what we need more. So I need to create a value spy file. I need to add for pack. So packet add for pack the project. Come on. Let's continue then. And I said that this is a value 5. I need to return what? This thing. Values. Okay. That's the implementation. Actually, the implementation will be this thing. It's already implemented. Okay. So my new state be a little bit different. Instead of last found will be the number of this is simple int. Let's implement this. I don't need that. The registers actually is a thing I need to provide, because I need to have separate values. So engine 0 will take instruction get engine of instructions, and register. Actually, it says something about an ID. It was something different. Yeah, I need to inject that value in the register. So actually, I don't like this name. I need to inject that value. And return the so this will be get a register. Open 0. And I need to have the mailboxes. I need to add compact first. And I need to provide them here. A and B. And this will be the other engine with a different ID. And the order will be inverse. Okay. need to run them. So it will be an engine 0 run in parallel with engine 1. It must be a value. Okay. Oh, I have that. So this, I remember right. I had some examples here. This, so it's is returning channels, and it has a job. So everything is a job. Let's do the same. So. So this will be a job. And everything. The common code. That's logic. A comment region of similar code and to software. Let's say here. Okay, but I need to fix this first. So the state is constant. So that this will return a job also. Okay. Come on. Oh, this will also be a job. And then state. So, I need to return, I said, a way to read. The value after everything is finished. So let's resolve. Eval int. It's a different thing. Now, when I'm finished, I need to return. actually do like this. So my var fill result with the state. And this is returning a job of units. So I need to do this. Okay, let's just not count. Let's collapse this for a moment and see what is different. So the different thing is the receive. Actually, let's do the sound first. So what is the sound? I don't know what's happening here, but I can select it like this also and move it down here for the sound. Let's collapse this and the region to be less scary. Why is it not? This is not happening anymore. So I need to have something like return of executes instructions. I can take the next stage. Okay. Okay, and I want those to go down. So this I also want to move it like that. Those are not needed anymore. Okay. Let's do that. Now, jumps is okay. Let's do the sound. So the sound is actually sending the value of x to other program. So, from the server perspective, I need to take this and mailbox send of server send channel of the value. The value will be get register get value of R. And this is a job. But I need to, after this, to go to the next next position. So this thing will be binded with this a function that will do what? Will do execute instruction for next state. I need to count a center value. But the value is sent when it's received. Let's count it here. So it will be a position. Position plus one. And count how was that? Count sent. And this go to that. So this will become a job. And with that job I can bind it. I see now. I need to have that. Okay. And let's see. If no values, are in the queue, it needs to wait. And if both of those are waiting, I need to terminate them. Let's do first the wait for the current value. So I will have a what? Mailbox. Instead of send, I need to take a value from client send channel this time. what to do with that. I need to store it in the register. So this is a an alternative. That is mainly a job. Actually, I think I have here. So this I can bind it to what? A function that receives a value, and with that value I'm updating the registers. And what else? And this will be the fun part. So, in this particular case, I need to get to the next thing and run it. So, next state execute instruction. And this will be a return. Okay. I have a job. That is anywhere. Not going. Come on. Okay, here. And I need to start. So I need something like this. What I need it on this. Blue star. And the queue does. I want this one. To ignore. Instead of server arm, I have execute. And my initial state. Where is my initial state? Will be 0 with 0. this is the result, if I remember right. As well as this. So, yeah, result. This is not needed anymore. Okay. What I didn't do until now, actually, let's do the red thing first. Okay, so my my duet is returning a job with two things and to read from an IVAR. Come on, not here. To the top. Here I want to search. Again. Okay, to read. Will block until I use this. So this will be two separate jobs combined in a single job, and I can bind it to a function of var 0 and var 1 that goes to var 0. Actually, for each, and I will the value of var 1. What? Ah, it's a, again, it's a job. And this. What is this? It's a map. What is happening here? It's that mod. It's a map. So I have a job of two jobs. No. Come on. And this I also can do like that. And now will be a job of twins. Okay. I'm fine with that. So if it's a job of twins, you do it. And I run the job, and after that I take which one was the program one, the is the second one, the second one, and compare with experiment. Okay. Nice. And I need to fix now the the blocking thing. Actually, let's see if this is running. Maybe my input will not block. But that is the most fun part. I need to... Ouch. I need to put server value. Okay, let's go here. And running examples. I don't have enough coffee. Nope. Okay, about this. I need to add it here. Oh, where did it go? File content. So yeah, I have a blocking input. Okay, I'm running again, so we block again, I assume. But I want to fix it. Close this. Collapse that. And to do it with the channels, to synchronize like that, I need to send from one channel to the other the message if I'm blocked. And both of them should send that and also should try to read that. And if they read, the fact that the other is blocked and also is blocked, the particular engine, then I should stop. Let's see. This, as expected, is in the deadlock. Okay. And this is the most fun part in that. So I need two more channels. Oh, how to call them? Kill pipe. And will be a channel of... I don't need the actual value. And those will be here. I don't know which keyboard shortcut I'm pressing, but come on! So much! Let's type it again. So this will be a job of doing. So let's do it. Second. I assume this is solved. The tree was sold also. What was I typing? Here. Oh, come on. Oh, heal pipe. Channel of units. Client send heal channel heal pipe. So yank and paste. Change till OS. Server send. Okay. And I need two more things. So kill A and kill B. And those will be a channel and a channel. And here I need to send the kill A, kill B. And here kill B and kill A. Swap it between those. And I need to use them. I know that somewhere here I have something like two. No. Yeah, this thing. Why not choose a chooser? No. This thing. Never. Interesting. So choose prepare function. Okay, so let's use it. So I have an alternate choose. And we'll receive a collection of things. And here another option in this thing is to first read from client send kill channel. So if I fail to read the value spike, it means that no value is on that, and I can get to a dead block, and I need to read from the client send kill channel. And if I'm able to read, that means that the other engine has sent also a kill signal. So if I read this, I want to what? To bind it to stop. The stop was implemented somewhere here. This is the stop. So let's extract it at scope engine workspace. Okay, so that means this the take will give me an unit, so I need a function that takes a parameter and is stopping the engine. Starting the engine, and I need to provide a state. I need to also send the value. Somewhere here, I remember that I saw some operators. Actually, I need a binding on the alternate. The binding on the alternate. Where is alternate? One thing that takes an alternate, this is the, those are the operators I need. So, from an alternate, it takes, it's like a binding, but it's accepting a job as the second, a job constructor as the second thing. So I need to, head equal later. Head equal later. Okay. Let's run those like that. So the take, we should also use the same operator, head equal operator. Nice. And I need to write the fact that I'm not able to read from the value spike to signal the other thread that we can enter a deadlock. So channel reverse send solution. I want to block I need to find channel. So I need to block, I need a synchronous answer, it's a give. Give of server send kill channel. So I'm sending the thing, and I need to provide a value. The value will be a unit, and I need also to provide a same signature. So in this case, will be on unit, okay, and stop engine of state. Cool. So because those are synchronous nodes, when both threads, both engines fail to read from the to receive a value, they will signal each other. Wow. Unexpected. I was expecting to take a longer time to fix it. Okay. So I need now to what? To run this and provide the default value. Run it again. And I did something about never here. Okay. On the streams. Yeah, never. An alternative that is never available. Okay. I have a focus test. Let's run it again. And nothing with the never. Where is the stop engine? So this will return a job of unit. And from the job, I can bind it to alternative never. To show my intent that this will never finish. Yes. Yes. Okay. The other implementation I was thinking of with the mailbox processor. I think it's easier to implement and easier to follow, but it had a drawback. In that implementation, I think either a locking mechanism or a receive with timeout, and I assume that the receive with timeout is the fastest thing to implement, but that means I need to wait for that timeout to pass. In this implementation, there is no timeout. In the moment that those enter the deadlock, those will update the IVAR, and the job will run here. Will read. So this will go on, but in the locked state, this will read the values. Everything will be fired by this, So I will not lose any more seconds. Actually, I can see. It's below 1 second everything. If I will need to do with a timeout, then I assume that I will need to give a big timeout, something like 10 seconds. So it's a real gain. That was the day 18. See you soon.